Today on BRStv Reef FAQs, we answer how to scrub the CO2 and raise your tank's pH. Hi, I'm Ryan, your host of BRStv Reef FAQs. Today we're talking CO2 scrubbers and how to raise the pH of your saltwater tank. For those of you looking for growth and metabolic health benefits of maintaining a pH of 8.3, scrubbing CO2 is one of the easiest and most reliable ways to achieve that goal. Presuming that you're already maintaining your tank's alkalinity properly, high carbon dioxide or CO2 in the room is the number one cause of low pH in your tank. All the excess CO2 in the room's air transfers to the tank and creates carbonic acid, which lowers the tank's pH. The excess CO2 in the room comes from all the people and pets breathing in it. It just often gets trapped in that room and builds up. An air exchanger on your home's AC or HVAC is the best solution. If you don't already have one, it's kind of expensive. You can also just open the windows to let the fresh air in and let the CO2 escape, but that isn't sustainable in the coldest or hottest months. However, that is the first step. Open your windows for 24 hours. If that solves your pH problem, then CO2 is your problem and controlling it is your solution. Once you've identified that's your issue, one of the easiest ways to solve it is just put a CO2 scrubber on your skimmer. The scrubber has a bunch of media that removes a vast majority of the carbon dioxide from the air. If we plug the skimmer's air intake into the scrubber, now all the air entering the skimmer has near zero CO2 and will prevent the formation of that excess carbonic acid in the tank and effectively raise the pH of the saltwater tank. The reason this works so well is because most of the skimmers out there draw so much air that the constant froth creates an air-water interface that greatly exceeds the gas exchange happening on the surface of the tank water. As the CO2 media gets depleted, it changes color and tells you when to change it. How long the media lasts is fairly dependent on the CO2 levels of your room and how much air your skimmer pulls, but it can be a week to a couple of weeks for a small 10-inch cartridge like this one. We put together a handful of solutions that range from a standard 10-inch cartridge to a larger cartridge, which should hold 4 times as much media, and a double option, which holds around 8 times as much. The double is what we use on our pH experiments just because it lasts so long between swaps. They can also be mounted on the wall, and they're also leg options. They all come with 3/8-inch barb fittings, and the skimmer air intake from most skimmers can just be ported right in. If you need adapters of any kind, we normally suggest the Kynar fittings in the ozone category just because there's a range of options from Ts, Ys, port sizes, and couplers. In many cases, it's just as easy as plugging it in and it will start working. However, in some cases, it may work too well and raise the pH more than you might like. In that case, you have 2 options for tuning, manually just by adding a Y fitting and a valve on the fresh air end of the Y. Potentially, you could put a valve on both and create a more refined mix, but it's probably not necessary. For the more technologically inclined, you can also use a Y, but put an electronic solenoid on the fresh air end. Many will just put it on the timer so the air is only scrubbed at night when the pH is the lowest. If you have a pH controller or a controller like the Apex, you can actually open and close the valve to create an ultra-stable pH 24 hours a day. We found 1 solenoid on the fresh air end to be adequate, but you could of course get more refined controls with 1 on each end. You can find solenoids on various places in the net, but we've used the push connect ones from McMaster Car in the past. I personally wish Neptune would make a 3/8-inch version of their solenoid for this application because it's getting pretty popular. If you'd like to see that, let them know in the comments down below. The community has to show a pretty strong demand for a brand new product like this one. So when is a CO2 scrubber not the best solution? Well, when CO2 isn't your issue. That's why we say open the windows for 24 hours and just confirm CO2 is your issue before considering a scrubber. The second reason a CO2 scrubber might not be the ideal solution is when you have a very small skimmer on a huge tank. If you have the smallest skimmer out there on a 200-gallon tank, it's possible the tank's natural gas exchange will outpace a tiny skimmer. It's also important to consider how to get the most out of your media. A cartridge is about $6 and the larger one around $24. No one wants more consumable medias to buy for their tank, but to be frank, there aren't many media options out there that will directly increase growth almost instantaneously. In our most recent BRStv investigates, we found that there was nearly 30% faster growth in 3 months. Extrapolated over a year, that could be close to double the coral growth. So if you have hundreds to thousands in tiny 1-inch coral frags in your tank, the $10 to $15 a month is a pretty compelling investment. Almost all of us want our tanks to go from this to this as fast as possible. However, there are ways to extend the life of the media and make the return on investment even higher First, if you have the best skimmer out there that draws the most air, you can consider splitting the line with a Y and a valve and draw partial fresh air. Related to that, by mixing the fresh air with scrubbed air on any skimmer, you might be able to, say, get a pH of 8.1 with half the media rather than 8.3, which will consume the media twice as fast. You can tune it to your needs and budget for your tank. We're actually in the process of setting up the next experiment on pH, this time with two identical tanks, this time to get past measuring weights and get to the core of the conversation, which is, will we really get double the growth in a year, and what does that actually look like in a tank? However, if you're interested in seeing the first experiment, we just completed and documented that 30% growth in 3 months. There it is. It's pretty darn interesting. See you next Wednesday with the next batch of BRStv Reef FAQs.